Wednesday, 10th August 2022. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. The Lord, even the most mighty God, has spoken and called the world from the rising of the sun to the going down thereof. Out of Zion, perfect in her beauty, has God shone forth in glory. Our God shall come and shall not keep silence. There shall go before him a consuming fire, and a mighty tempest shall be stirred up round about him. He shall call to the heavens above and to the earth beneath, that he may judge his people. Gather my faithful together unto me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens shall declare his righteousness, for God himself is judge. Oh, hear, O my people, and I will speak. I myself will testify against you, O Israel, for I am God, even your God. I will not rebuke you because of your sacrifices or for your burnt offerings, because they are always before me. I will take no bull calf out of your house, nor he goat out of your folds. for all the beasts of the forest are mine, and so are the cattle upon 8,000 hills. I know all the birds of the air, and the wild beasts of the field are in my sight. If I were hungry, I would not tell you, for the whole world is mine, and all that is therein. Do you think that I will eat the flesh of bulls and drink the blood of goats? Offer unto God a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and pay your vows unto the Most High, and call upon me in the time of trouble. So will I hear you, and you shall praise me. But to the ungodly God says, why do you recite my laws and take my covenant in your mouth, though you hate to be disciplined and have cast my words behind you? When you saw a thief, you agreed with him, and you have taken part with adulterers. You have let your mouth speak wickedness, and with your tongue you have set forth deceit. You sat and spoke against your brother, yes, and have slandered your own mother's son. These things you have done, and I held my tongue, and you thought wickedly that I am such a one as yourself. But I will reprove you, and set before you the things that you have done. Oh, consider this, you who forget God, lest I tear you in pieces, and there be none to deliver you. Whoever offers me a sacrifice of thanksgiving honors me, and to him who orders his way aright will I show the salvation of God. Have mercy upon me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the multitude of your mercies, wipe away my offenses. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done this evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless in your judgment. But behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and shall make me understand wisdom secretly. You shall purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. You shall wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. You shall make me hear of joy and gladness. That the bones which you have broken may rejoice. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my misdeeds. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. O give me the comfort of your help again, and sustain me with your willing spirit. Then shall I teach your ways unto the wicked, and sinners shall return unto you. Deliver me from blood guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. For you desire no sacrifice, or else I would give it to you. But you delight not in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you shall not despise. O be favorable and gracious unto Zion, and may you build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you shall be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with the burnt offerings and oblations. Then shall they offer your bullocks upon your altar. Why do you boast, you tyrant, that you can do evil, whereas the goodness of God endures all the day long? Your tongue devises wickedness, and with lies you cut like a sharp razor. You have loved unrighteousness more than goodness, and to utter lies more than truth. You have a love to speak all words to hurt, O you deceitful tongue. Therefore God shall destroy you forever. He shall catch you and pluck you out of your dwelling, and root you out of the land of the living. The righteous also shall see this in fear, and shall laugh him to scorn. Behold, this is the one who did not take God for his strength, but trusted in the multitude of his riches and relied on his wickedness. As for me, I am like a green olive tree in the house of God. My trust is in the tender mercy of God forever and ever. I will always give thanks unto you for what you have done, and I will declare your name among the faithful, for it is good. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel, beginning with the 29th chapter, the first verse. Now the Philistines had gathered all their forces at Aphek, and the Israelites were encamped by the spring that is in Jezreel. And the lords of the Philistines were passing on by hundreds and by thousands, and David and his men were passing on in the rear with Achish. The commanders of the Philistines said, "What are these Hebrews doing here?" And Achish said to the commanders of the Philistines, "Is this not David, the servant of Saul, king of Israel, who has been with me now for days and years, and since he deserted to me, I have found no fault in him to this day." But the commanders of the Philistines were angry with him, and the commanders of the Philistines said to him, "Send the man back, that he may return to the place to which you have assigned him. He shall not go down with us to battle, lest in the battle he become an adversary to us. For how could this fellow reconcile himself to his Lord? Would it not be with the heads of the men here? Is not this David, of whom they sing to one another in dances? Saul has struck down his thousands, and David his 10,000s. Then Achish called David and said to him, "As the Lord lives, you have been honest, and to me it seems right that you should march out and in with me in the campaign. For I have found nothing wrong in you from the day of you coming to me to this day. Nevertheless, the lords do not approve of you. So go back now and go peaceably, that you may not displease the lords of the Philistines." And David said to Achish, "But what have I done? What have you found in your servant from the day I entered your servants? The day I entered your service until now, that I may not go and fight against the enemies of my lord the king?" And Achish answered David and said, "I know that you are as blameless in my sight as an angel of God. Nevertheless, the commanders of the Philistines have said, 'He shall not go up with us to the battle.'" Now then, rise early in the morning with the servants of your Lord who came with you, and start early in the morning, and depart as soon as you have light. So David set out with his men exactly in the morning. Set with his men early in the morning, to return to the land of the Philistines. But the Philistines went up to Jezreel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has dawned upon you. For behold, darkness covers the land, deep gloom enshrouds the peoples. But over you the Lord will rise, and his glory will appear upon you. Nations will stream to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawning. Your gates will always be open by day or night, they will never be shut. They will call you the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Violence will no more be heard in your land, ruin or destruction within your borders. You will call your walls salvation, and all your portals praise. The sun will no more be your light by day. By night you will not need the brightness of the moon. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from St. Paul's Epistle to the Romans, beginning with the 10th chapter, the first verse. Brothers, my heart's desire and prayer to God for them is that they may be saved. For I bear them witness that they have a zeal for God, but not according to knowledge. For being ignorant of the righteousness of God and seeking to establish their own, they did not submit to God's righteousness. For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. For Moses writes about the righteousness that is based on the law, that the person who does the commandments shall live by them. But the righteousness based on faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven, that is, to bring Christ down, or who will descend into the abyss, that is, to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart, that is, the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. For the scripture says, everyone who believes in him will not be put to shame, for there is no distinction between Jews and Greeks. For the same Lord is Lord of all, bestowing his riches on all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How then will they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching? And how are they to preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Lord, Who has believed what he has heard from us? So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. But I ask, have they not heard? Indeed they have, for their voice has gone out to all the earth, and their words to the ends of the world. But I ask, did Israel not understand? First, Moses says, I will make you jealous of those who are not a nation, and with a foolish nation, I will make you angry. And Isaiah is so bold as to say, I have been found by those who did not seek me. I have shown myself to those who did not ask for me. But of Israel, he says, all day long I have held out my hands to a disobedient and contrary people. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, Guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, give us the increase of faith, hope, and love, that we may obtain what you have promised. Make us love what you command. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, you have brought us safely to the beginning of this day. Defend us by your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor run into any danger, and that, guided by your Spirit, we may do what is righteous in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the Father, Creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, Sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears. Neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation, good Lord, deliver us. From all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity, good Lord, deliver us. From all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil, good Lord, deliver us. From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments, good Lord, deliver us. From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine, good Lord, deliver us. From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared, good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us. In all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your Holy Church Universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. to bless and keep all your people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally, to beat down Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions, With pity behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us. O Lord Christ, let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us all. Rescue us from all those evils we now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O most mighty and merciful God, in this time of grievous sickness we flee to you for comfort. Deliver us, we beseech you, from our peril. Give strength and skill to all those who minister to the sick. Prosper the means made use of for their cure, and grant that, perceiving how frail and uncertain our life is, we may apply our hearts unto that heavenly wisdom which leads to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and immortal God, giver of life and health, we implore your mercy for your servants. We implore your mercy for your servants who are sickened by this virus, that by your blessing upon them and upon those who minister to them with your healing gifts, they may be restored to health of body and mind according to your gracious will, and may give thanks to you in your holy church, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen.